time, I think we are going to have to ask for closing comments because we have other panelists planned this afternoon, or this morning. So I think the only fair way to do this that I know of is alphabetical order. So Dennis, if you want to kick us off, that would be
what, 1 minute, 2 minutes?
Two and a half minutes, Huey.
Well, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure to be here with you and having a chance to have a good dialogue like this. It's part of the election campaign. It's an important part, as I mentioned before, because, you know, what election campaigns also do is crystallize ideas in people's minds about where we're going in this territory. That's a very helpful thing. So the forums are important like that. I would encourage all people to attend all forums. It's something that I've done in 5 elections. I haven't missed a forum, a chance to talk to people once. Why do I do that? Because that's my style. I listen to people. I go to communities all over the North. I go to groups. I talk to them. I find out what they want. I help them in Ottawa. That's my goal. My goal is not to bring Ottawa's message back to you like we used to have. My goal, and always has been, is to take our message to Ottawa, make sure it's heard. As an opposition MP, I've worked hard to do that. I'm in the top 15% of people that speak in Parliament last year, the amount of words. I get up there on my feet for you, day in, day out. And that's what I'll continue to do. If I am so lucky as to see that our party has a chance to be part of government, I'll take that role on as well. I was a mayor for many years. I love running things. I can run things very well. I take care of things very well. So I'm not worried about the government side if we have an opportunity to do that. I will feel very comfortable there as well. I work for consensus even in Ottawa. That's why that Northern Report had everybody on side, because we worked to get a consensus among all the parties. That's why I got my private members bill passed, except for the conservatives who agreed with the idea but wouldn't vote with us because they don't like giving any political advantage to anyone else. You know, that's sad. That was a sad thing that the 140 conservative MPs stood up against something that was so plainly needed by the North and was so supported by everyone else. But they do it for political reasons. Anyhow, I'll work for you as I have done in the past. I've got a record. You can trust me. On May 2nd, please consider my candidacy.
Thank you, everyone, and thank you for giving us extra time to answer the questions, and I'm sure there's lots more good questions out there, too. When I first did my opening remarks, I asked you a question, and that is, are you better off as a result of the last 5 years? And I don't think there's many Northerners who would say, yeah, I'm way better off. Harper's government's been great for us, and the NDP as our representative has been great for the North. That's not the case with most people I've talked to. It's a question you have to ask yourself, you answered yourself. Now, I'm running for the Liberals because I believe in the platform. I believe in people. I believe in getting our people healthy, educated, employed, and I also believe in respect for all people, Aboriginal, new Canadians, business people, every sector. We've got to work together. There's only 40-some thousand of us here. We've got to hang together here. I believe we'll be the government. There's a big section of uncommitted voters out there, and they're not way over in the right and they're not way over in the left. And they're coming out. We had the open, wasn't a closed event. We had a barbecue when Ignatia was here. We had about 500 people show up. We had students with placards saying, we want to vote. We're going to vote. And I think we're seeing a movement across this country that's going to be something that we haven't seen in previous elections. People want change. I'm running on my record of what I achieve, not Sandy's revisionist history of what happened. I deliver. I'm honest with you, I'll deliver. And whether it's on infrastructure projects or whether it's on anything else. She said I worked for ATCON. I did 2 short projects. I did one looking, they asked me to look at the bridge at the Peel River that the people were asking for there. I did that, it was all within the limits. 6 months after my time to do that kind of consultant work was done. And the second one I looked at was the thought of continuing the all-weather road up from Tibbet towards Gordon Lake. That's all I did. Within limits, I got to make a living too.
Time draw.
Okay, and I'm open.
Yeah.
Thank you. Seeing as he brought it up, our members were so offended by what happened that we in fact passed a legislation that prohibits any minister from working with any company for 2 years that had anything to do with any department. That, you know, we, for a common sense point of view, is very offensive. I just want to say that on May 2nd, our voters in the territories are faced with a very clear choice. We have an NDP MP, we have one MP seat for entire Northwest Territories, 33 communities. The question is, how, what kind of a voice do we want with that seat? Choice you have is to have an NDP MP or have an MP within the government. We do not have a luxury of having a Liberal MP, NDP MP, and Conservative MP who could go there and voice our opinions. We have a choice of electing a Conservative MP who will be at the table within the Conservative caucus and Northern caucus the Prime Minister has created, just made up of all of the Northern territories in which currently sit MP and Senator from Nunavut and Senator from Yukon. They get to write a memo to the Prime Minister every week about what the Northern priorities are, economically, socially, politically. Our choice is, do you want to send Sandy Lee at that table so that every day, 7 days a week, you can have an influence and you could have a say on what the future of the government is. I think everybody understands that we're gonna have a Conservative government. So we need to make that choice. And I ask you on May 2nd to consider voting for Sandy Lee. Thank you.
I think everybody knows and understands that on May 2nd we're going to have a green government. I can't tell the future. What I am tired of is half-truths. I could sit here and make note of every little slip-up or every minor inaccuracy that my colleagues have stated or whatnot throughout this event or the entire campaign. That's not what I'm about. I'm about me. What I'm running on, my three promises, people first, party second, all the MP half the salary, and open government. That's what I'm running on. I know that when I'm elected, I'm going to work for the people of the Northwest Territories. I'm going to spend so much money on new shoes just from walking through Parliament, walking to different offices, setting up meetings, working my ass off to make sure that when a good idea comes up, I support it. And when I generate good ideas, I get the support of other parties to get the job done. That's what I'm running on. I believe that yes, we do have one MP, and we need to make sure that it's an MP who goes to Ottawa, represents the people of the Northwest Territories, and works with whoever is governing. Conservatives, Liberals, NDP, whoever is forming the government, to make sure that Northern issues are at the table, to make sure that just because you're not part of the government, your issues are being addressed and you're being listened to, even if it means sitting outside the Prime Minister's office until he takes your call. The most important thing is having an MP who represents the people of the Northwest Territories and works with the other MPs in Ottawa to make government work for Canada. I encourage you to talk to your families, talk to your colleagues, talk to your kids, talk to your parents. Find out the issues, find out what each of the candidates stands for, and vote on May 2nd or in the early ballots or today, whenever. Go in and vote for who you think best represents you.
Time.
Thank you.
On behalf of the NWT Chamber, I'd certainly like to thank all of the candidates for giving us your time today, your enthusiasm and passion and words, I'm sure, will be taken to heart by many of us, and we really appreciate your time. Thanks so much for coming in.